Good morning, everyone. I am Kutredi. Welcome you all to this session. Okay. And in last session, we have completed our chapter friction. And today we are going to start this, your chapter 9, reproduction in animals. So first of all, remember the chapter reproduction in plants we have studied in this class 7. Okay. In previous class. Okay. Previous standard, we can say. So this is the quite similar to that chapter only. Okay, so you might be aware with this reproduction. Although, what is reproduction? Can anyone remember this thing? So the production of new individuals from their parent is simply known as reproduction. Okay, you might have observed that we humans are getting baby, okay, for our next generation. Okay, your parents are the reproduction to your grandfather only, your grandparents only. Okay, so this is the cycle. And after this, apart from this, other animals also will have reproduction. Okay, so for that you are given table 9.1 in your textbook. Okay, so just pause the video and open your textbook and open this table 9.1. Okay, if you are given this on 102, okay, page number 102. Okay, so they have given these two examples, human and hen. Okay, for human, this young one animal is baby. Okay, we are telling baby. And what about this hen? This is chick. Okay, but what about others animals? What are the young one of the other animals? Okay, so pause the video for a while and go for it. Okay, just write it down, this young one to this animals 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7. Okay, because 1 and 5 you are given. So this is the young one to this animals. Okay, for cat we can tell kitten. Okay, kitten becomes cat one day. After this puppy, okay, the baby dog, we can say, okay, is puppy only. Butterfly, okay, butterfly comes from caterpillar, we can say. After this hen, you are given chick. Cow is calf. Okay, and you can see this calf in village area also. Okay, so and next one is frog, tadpole, and sometimes they said frog land also. Okay, so these are the names for the young one to these animals. Okay, these animals you are asking in this table, you are being asked in this table 9.1. So next one is, let's go for some modes of reproduction. Okay, so as we have studied for these plants, there are two modes by which animals also can reproduce. Okay, and these two modes are mainly sexual and asexual reproduction. But before this, let me recall some points, important points from this reproduction in plants only. Okay, from this class 7. So most plants have roots, stems, and leaves. Okay, you might have observed these things in almost each and every plants. Okay, so what these things are addressed? Okay, these things are called as vegetative parts. Okay, vegetative parts of a plant. Okay, simply the parts which can be eaten by us. Okay, which can be eaten by us or any other animals are simply vegetative parts. Okay, so keep it in mind. And next one is the flowers. Okay, you might have observed that plants are getting some flowers in the springs. Okay, in the spring. So after these, they are getting fruits and any other thing on it in next season, we can say. So we have already gone for the example of mango tree in class 7. Okay, you might have observed this in mango tree, that this mango tree is getting some flowers in spring, and we are getting some juicy mangoes. Okay, we can enjoy these juicy mangoes in summer only. So the flowers perform the function of reproduction in plants, and these flowers are these flowers are the reproductive parts of the plants. Okay, So can you guys enlist the reproductive parts of the animals also? Or before going to eat, okay, first of all, enlist the, can you name this parts of reproductive parts in these plants? Okay, because we already seen that some of these plants are going for sexual reproduction, and some are going to this asexual reproduction. So can you guys enlist this parts, reproductive parts from these plants only? Okay. And after enlisting these parts, okay, find out the, first of all, let me tell you that you might have observed that some of these plants are going to reproduce them sexually. Okay, so enlist the enlist these parts, okay, male and female parts from this reproductive parts. Okay, so let me give you this definition of this asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Okay, so simply you can just remember that sexual reproduction, let me start from this sexual reproduction, okay, that you can just remember, and there is no need to mug up. Okay, so in sexual reproduction, new plants are obtained from seeds only. Okay, sexual reproduction means seeds. Okay, they need some seeds for the reproduction. And asexual reproduction, in asexual reproduction, plants can give rise to the new plants without seeds. Okay, this was the definition you have already studied in this reproduction in plants. Okay, so as it is, okay, let's go for the sexual reproduction, your topic 9.2 from the textbook. Okay, so let's go for the definition. First of all, reproduction that beginning from the fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. So male and female reproductive parts of plants that reproduce sexually. You might have enlist this male and female reproductive parts of plants. Okay, after these reproductive parts produce gametes. Okay, and these gametes fuse to form a zygote. Okay, and this zygote is developed to a new individual of parent. Okay, so this is the whole process, and whichever the reproduction type of reproduction follow this process is simply known as sexual reproduction. So let's go for the definition once again. Reproduction that beginning from the fusion of male and female gametes is called sexual reproduction. Okay, so I'm getting my point. I hope you are clear with this sexual reproduction. Okay, and in next session we will go for some male reproductive organs. Okay, and female reproductive organs. Okay, that what are the paths we are using, we people are using, okay, humans are using for this sexual reproduction. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you very much, all of you. Have a nice day.